welcome to the first ever episode of Charger Family Feud. Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and get started.
We have from Cary, North Carolina, Team Red John. And from Cary, North Carolina, Team Marvin. All right, give me Mr. Lassiter, give me Marvin. This is what's going to happen. I'm gonna ask a question, and whoever presses the buzzer first gets to answer first. But that doesn't mean that your team's getting the round, because it depends. Whoever gets the highest ranking answer to the question is going to get to go to their team. Are we ready?
Oh, we are ready.
Indeed. Are you sure?
Very.
Indubitably.
Okay. First question. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket. Mr. Lassiter, name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They lie.
You said they lie. Survey says...
Oh.
That hurts a little. That hurts, doesn't it?
Shame.
All right, Marvin, are you ready?
Not particularly.
Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They apologize.
Marvin says they apologize. Survey says... We're all thinking, aren't we?
Look at that!
All right!
Not bad, Team Marvin, not bad!
Basically apologizing.
Are you going to play?
Are you going to play or pass this round?
We're gonna play.
All right, they're playing.
All right, Team Marvin's, gonna play. Get down there. All right, now sit down. Okay. All right, second contestant, please come up and introduce yourself. What's your name, young lady?
My name is Dina.
Okay, Dina, and what do you do for a living?
I'm a contractor.
Sounds good. We've got the top 8 answers on the board. Marvin already got the 3rd answer. I'm gonna ask the question again. You're gonna say it, and we're gonna see if it's up there. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They kiss up to the officer.
You said they kiss up to the officer. Survey says?
Woo!
Blurred. All right, good answer. Woo! All right, let me have the next contestant. Introduce yourself, young lady.
My name's Samantha.
Hello, Samantha. And what do you do for a living?
I own a Smoothie King.
Nice. Go to Smoothie King. All right, so I'm going to ask the question one more time. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They start crying.
They cry. You said cry. Survey says? Ding, ding, ding. All right, that's the number one answer. All right, Talia, get up here. All right, a little faster, please. Okay, Talia, tell me a little something about yourself. What do you do for fun?
I breed snails.
You breed snails?
Yes.
Anyways. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They drive away.
Okay. You said drive away. Survey says? Drive away. Okay. Anyways, Marvin, continuing on. Let's go.
Let's do it.
All right. There are 4 answers open left. You have no misses. You give this a go. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket. Come on there, let's go.
They go to the courthouse.
They go to the courthouse. You said they go to the courthouse, survey says?
What?
That is unfortunate. Down there. All right, one more, Dina, get up here. All right, your team has 2 wrong answers so far. If you miss, the teachers have a chance to steal. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They try to bribe the officer.
They try to bribe the officer. You said bribe, survey says? This survey. Okay, anyways, one more person, get up here. So far, there are 3 answers left. Samantha, you have 2 misses. If you miss this, the teachers have a chance to steal. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They pretend they didn't see the speeding sign.
They pretend they didn't see a speeding sign. Survey says? Oh, that's too bad. Now the teachers, they have a chance to steal. First contestant, come up. Oh, what are you thinking? All right. Name something people do to get out of a speeding ticket.
They say they have an emergency.
They say they have an emergency. You said emergency. Survey says? Oh, and the students get all the points. Team Marvin takes the lead. All right,
let's
next round.
All right, guys. Give me Dr. Mazzaro. Give me Dina.
Going to go just like the last round, except with a little bit more pressure. Who's ready?
Woo!
I'm ready.
Name something a dog would bark at. Team Marvin, name
squirrel.
You said squirrel. Survey says. All right, Dr. Mazzaros.
The doorbell.
You said the doorbell. Survey says.
Oh, since Team Marvin got the buzzer first, they get to go. Would you guys like to pass or play?
Play.
Play. All right. Okay, Samantha, get up here. And the second question, name something a dog would bark at.
Another dog.
Oh, you said another dog. Survey says? All right, good answer. All right, next person, Talia, come up here. Talia, do you own any pets?
Yes, I do.
What pets do you have?
I have a dog and cats and gerbils.
Nice, nice. Okay, well then you should be familiar.
Yes.
Name something a dog would bark at.
The mailman.
You said the mailman. Survey says? The number one answer, all right. Okay, cool, and next contestant. All right, for Team Marvin. Marvin, do you have any dogs?
I have one dog.
What's her name? His or her name?
Jefferson's name is Jefferson.
Jefferson's name is Jefferson. Okay, then name something Jefferson would bark at.
A cat.
A cat, okay. Sir.
Or multiple cats.
You said cat or multiple cats. Survey says?
Good answer, guys!
Hey!
5 points. All right, Dina, get up here. Team Marvin seems to be dominating the competition right now. You've got 2 answers left. No wrong answer so far for your team. No pressure here. Name something that a dog would bark at.
A baby.
Dina, do you have dogs? Survey says no. Samantha, get up here. Next question. Our next contestant. Name something a dog would bark at.
A car.
A car. You said car. Survey says. All the pressure's up. Talia, get back up here. There's 2 wrong answers so far. If you miss this, the teachers have a chance to steal. Name something a dog would bark at.
Food.
Food. And, okay. You said food. Survey says? Okay, anyways. Marvin, get up here. It seems to be the team captain. There's 1 answer left to take all the points on the board.
All the points. All
if
the points.
If you miss this, the teachers have a chance to steal. Name
Devil.
Something a dog would bark at.
Horses. Jefferson barks at horses.
Horses. Okay, horses.
It's horses.
You said horses. Survey says? Okay. And the teachers have a chance to steal. A little bit of time to discuss. I don't know if Marvin owns horses. That's a little bit, that's interesting. Well, what do you think? Name something a dog would bark at.
Thunder or storm.
Thunder or storm, good answer. Survey says? Oh. I want to see the final answer. What's number 5? Nothing? Who made this survey? Okay, anyways, and that concludes the next round. Team Marvin gets all the points. Okay.
All right, guys. Give me Senora Torreson and give me Samantha. Come on, guys.
think you guys are gonna like this next one. Uh-oh. Are you ready? Name a profession that starts with a T. Senora Torreson?
Teacher.
You said teacher, which is funny, because you were a teacher. Survey says that's the number one answer. That means immediately.
We're gonna play.
You want to play? No. They want to play.
Play. Woo, yeah. All right. Team Red Dawn. Hello. Introduce yourself. What's your name?
Miss Burnett.
Miss Burnett. And what do you teach?
Science.
All right. Science. Name a profession that starts with T.
Taylor.
Taylor. You said Taylor. Survey says. That's unfortunate. All right, next contestant. Mr. Lassiter, name a profession that starts with the letter T.
A technician.
A technician. Everybody says? Next contestant. Okay, and what's your name?
Dr. Mazaros.
Dr. Mazaros, nice to meet you. And what do you teach?
History.
Very nice. Okay, name a profession that starts with the letter T.
Can I phone a friend?
That's not this game show.
I don't know. That's I can't unlucky. Think of one.
Oh, then that's a wrong answer, right? She can't think of anything.
T.
I'll give you a second. 5, 4, 3, 2.
I got nothing.
Well, now I got nothing.
Sorry.
Okay, that's all right. No worries. Next contestant, Ms. Torreson. There are two wrong answers so far. If you get one more wrong, Team Marvin has a chance to steal.
Uh-oh.
Name a profession that starts with T.
A TV actor or actress.
A TV actor or actress. Survey says? Unfortunate. All right, now Team Marvin has a chance to steal. So far, dominating the board. You guys have an idea of what you would like?
Somebody knows.
Somebody knows? All right. Talia, get up here a little quicker if you can.
Sorry.
Name a profession that starts with the letter T.
A therapist.
A therapist. Survey says?
No!
Oh, and the teachers get on the board. All right. Let's see the answers. Number 3. Telemarketer. Truck driver. And taxi driver. All right, and that concludes round number 3. We're moving to round number 4. Emily, take it away.
I'm going to be... Woo! Last question before we have the lightning round. All right. Give me Miss Burnett. Give me Talia. All right, guys, your costume. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm feeling good.
How are you feeling? All right. Name what you would do first on a deserted island. Hey, Steve Harvey, did you see who clicked first?
I'm going to give that to the teacher, Steve Harvey.
Teachers! All right. Name what you would do first on a deserted island.
Put on sunscreen.
You said put on sunscreen. Survey says. I guess no one cares about skin cancer these days. Talia, name what you would do first on a deserted island.
Look for water.
You said look for water. Survey says. That's the first answer!
All right, and Team Marvin is going to...
Pass or play!
Play, they're playing!
Good answer.
Okay, Marvin, get up here. We're doing the first question.
Excellent.
So let's go. Name something you would do first on a deserted island.
Signal for help.
You would signal for help, survey says.
Hey!
Let's go. All right, next person. Nina, get up here. Currently, your team is dominating with 170 plus points while the teachers only have 70. How does that make you feel?
Just makes me feel like I'm dominating.
Yeah, I get that. Okay. Name what you would do first on a deserted island.
I would go tan.
You would go tan. Survey says? Skin cancer. All right, Samantha, get up here. Name something you would do first on a deserted island.
I would build a shelter.
Build a shelter, good answer.
Good answer.
Survey says?
Woo!
Okay, all right. Talia, come up here. All right, there are two answers left. Your team hasn't missed a single one. You guys have a chance to clear, besides Dina, you guys have a chance to clear the board. Name something you would do first on a deserted island.
Look for food.
Look for food. Survey says?
Good answer.
Oh my. Okay, Marvin. All right, Marvin. There's one more answer right now. There's one more answer left on the board.
I know what it is.
You know what it is?
Oh, I know precisely what it is.
Okay. Name something you would do first on a deserted island.
Construct a boat.
You said construct a boat. Survey says?
What kind of person doesn't build a boat?
That's unfortunate. Now, the teachers have a... Okay, that was just bad. Okay, we have one more chance, Dina, get up here. Okay. Your team has gotten two wrong and so far, and you've been responsible for half of the misses that your team has so far.
I look at the glass half full.
I understand. You have one chance. Name something. Name what you would do first on a deserted island.
Make friends.
On a deserted island?
With the fishes.
Okay. Make friends on a deserted island.
With the fishes.
Survey says?
With the fishes.
And now the teachers have a chance to steal. All right. A little bit of discussion. What are we thinking? Name what you would do first on a deserted island.
We'd build a fire.
You build a fire. Survey says?
No!
And the teachers have caught up to the Team Marvin. And that concludes round four. Steve Harvey misspoke. We've actually got more rounds to go. Okay, the next contestants, please come up to the podium.
Yeah, Marvin!
Sorry, guys. I'm just a little... There's more rounds. Don't you worry about that. I misspoke last time. All right, guys. Sorry to get your hopes up, but this one's a good one. This one's a good one, all right? Who's ready? Name a kind of cheese. Marvin?
Swiss.
You said Swiss. Survey says... All right, Mr. Lassiter, you have a chance. If you get the number one answer, it's going to your team to pass or play. All right, name a kind of cheese.
Cheddar.
You said cheddar. Survey says?
And the teachers take that round. Are you guys going to play? They're playing. Woo! Yes. All right, Dr. Mazaras, get up here. Are you familiar with cheese?
I love cheese.
Oh, yes, me too. So name a kind of cheese.
Brie.
Say that again.
Brie.
Brie. She says Brie. Survey says?
Bummer.
Okay, next contestant. Torreson. Name a kind of cheese.
Blue cheese.
Blue cheese. You said blue cheese. Survey says? All right, get out the way. Blue Woo! Cheese. All right. Ms. Burnett, let's go. Name a kind of cheese.
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella. She said mozzarella. Alright. Mr. Lassiter, name a kind of cheese.
American.
American cheese. Survey says? American cheese, alright. The cheese expert, name a kind of cheese.
Gouda.
Gouda cheese. Survey says? All right, now Team Marvin has a chance to steal. There are two answers on the board. You only have one chance with this one. Who's up? Dina, Dina's got this. If you get this wrong, the teachers actually take the lead in this round.
Don't worry, guys.
Okay, name a kind of cheese.
Parmesan.
Oh, Parmesan cheese. Survey says...
No! Oh.
All right, what are the other two answers?
This is
Let's
wrong.
Take a look. Longhorn cheese. And okay, I'm seriously considering firing you, Sophia. Anyways, okay, moving on to the next round. Team Red Dawn takes the lead.
Are you ready? Because this one's a good one. It's not so cheesy like the last one. Name someone in a circus who, if they sneezed, would die during their act. Team Marvin.
The guy riding the elephant.
You said the guy riding the elephant. Survey says... What type of circuses are you going to?
The ones with the guy riding the elephant.
I've been to a few circus shows myself. Steve Harvey gets the front row seats.
Survey says?
Ah!
Survey says,
ah. All right, Dr. Mazzaros. Name someone in a circus who, if they achoo, would die during the act.
Acrobat.
You said acrobat. Survey says.
Yeah.
All right, pass or play.
Play.
They've okay. chosen.
Teachers, Team Red Dawn is going to play. Neurotorsen, let's go. Okay, so the question: name someone in a circus who, if they sneeze during their act, would die.
The tiger handler.
You said tiger handler. Survey says. All right. Internet, science teach. All right. Name someone in a circus who, if they sneezed, would die during the act.
The guy juggling flamethrowers.
The guy juggling flamethrowers. You said flamethrower. Survey says? Juggler. Chainsaw. Holy crap. Ambassador, get ready. Name someone who, in a circus, if they sneezed, would die during their act.
A tightrope walker.
Survey says? Red Dawn is making a comeback, Dr. Mazzaros. Okay, name someone in a circus who, if they sneezed, would die during their act. You got this?
I don't have this.
You got it?
I'm trying to think of people who work at circuses. Haven't we said everything?
You got a chance.
The person who walks on the elephants? Like they straddle the elephants, or they straddle the animals, and they walk. I don't know what their name is.
That sounds familiar. Anyways, the person who's walking on the elephants. Survey says. Oh, that's unlucky. Next time. All right, Senora Torreson, give this a go. Your team is currently in the lead. If you take this, you win the entire game. Name someone in a circus who, if they sneezed, would die during the act.
Person getting shot out of the cannon.
Oh, the person getting shot out of the cannon. Survey says. Oh, clown are doing stunts. Okay. Ms. Burnett, so far only one wrong answer. Name someone who, in a circus, if they sneezed, would die during their act.
The poodle on the ball.
The poodle would die. The poodle on the ball. It's a big ball, apparently. Survey says, that's unlucky, okay. And Mr. Lassiter? Oh, Lassiter, okay, anyways. You have one chance here.
Oh, no.
Okay, don't worry, I'm keeping track. You've got two wrong answers so far. If you miss this, Team Marvin has a chance to steal and take the game. Name someone who, in a circus, who, if they sneezed during their act, would die.
The fire swallower.
The fire swallower. Survey says? Fire eater. Okay, okay. One more. Let's go. You got it, you got it. Okay. You've had a little time to think?
I thought about one.
All right, good, good. Name someone who in a circus, name someone in a circus who, if they sneezed, would die during the act.
The person who rides the motorcycle in the big wheel.
Oh, good answer. The person who rides the motorcycle in the big wheel. Survey says? Survey says?
No.
Oh, and that's three. Team Marvin. Team Marvin has the chance to take the entire game. You guys, okay? This decides the fate of who goes into the lightning round, Samantha. You only have one chance to answer this. Name someone who in a circus, who if they sneeze would die during the act.
The person on stilts.
Good answer, good answer.
She said the person on stilts. Survey says.
Good answer, good answer.
Good. And Team Red Dawn wins. All right, all right, all right. And now we move on to the lightning round. Okay, you guys are going to nominate two people to be in the lightning round. Do you know who's going to be? All right, Mr. Burnett. And Emily's going to take you with. Let's go, Team Red Dawn. Woo!
All right, I'm going to explain how this is going to work. We're going to go speed round through five questions. Mr. Lassiter can answer one answer per question. At the end, we're going to see, were his answers really what Family Feud was looking for? And then Miss Burnett's going to do it all over again. If they win 200 points, they're getting a big breakfast next week. All right. Mr. Lassiter, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Name something people do to corn.
Shuck it.
Name a product that might be disposable.
A styrofoam cup.
Name an excuse teachers give their parents for coming home. Teenagers give their parents for coming home late.
Traffic.
Name something that comes in a spray bottle.
Bathroom smell spray?
And name something people hide under their bed.
Shoes.
All right. Now it's time to go over those answers. First question. Name something people do to corn. You said, shuck it. Survey says. Oh, 5 points. Okay, that makes it dead. Next question. Name a product that might be disposable. You said styrofoam cups, which, might I add, are really bad for the environment. Survey says 4 points. All right. This one is a good one. I think a lot of the viewers might be poking at this one. Name an excuse teenagers give their parents for coming home late. You said traffic. Survey says 3 points. Name something that comes in a spray bottle. You said bathroom smelly stuff.
Yes.
Survey says 7 points. That's your highest so far.
Consistent.
And last one. Name something people hide under their bed. You said shoes. Survey says 23. Are you ready?
I am so ready.
Name something people do to corn.
Eat it.
Name a product that might be disposable.
Masks.
Name an excuse teenagers give their parents for coming home late.
My chips were stuck in the vending machine.
Name something that comes in a spray bottle.
Hand sanitizer.
Name something people hide under their bed.
Money.
All right. Are you ready to go over these answers?
Yes.
Your team needs 158 points if you want to win that big breakfast.
Ooh.
All right. First question. Name something people do to corn. You said, eat it. I had corn for dinner last night. Survey says, 26! Name a product that might be disposable. You said a mask, which, wear your mask, kids. Survey says, name an excuse teenagers give their parents for coming home late. You said their chips were stuck in the vending machine. Survey says, that's tough luck.
I got that as an excuse for class.
Name something that comes in a spray bottle. You said hand sanitizer. Survey says, all right, guys, this is fate determining. The question was, name something people hide under their bed. You said money. Survey says,
okay, 97 points, not bad. And that concludes the very first episode of Charger Family Feud. Give it up for Team Marvin. And the winner, Team Red Dawn. Thank you for watching, and tune in some other time for episode number 2. I'm Steve Harvey.
And I'm Steve Harvey.
And we'll see you next time.